I remember like a guy slapped my ass on site in Invercargill, and I went and told like someone straight away. His response was to like make a joke of it, and then like 10 minutes later he recreated the ass slap on me and was like, "Oh, look, I'm that guy." Just the ignorance of people to understand like the shit we go through is the worst part for sure. Hi, I'm Brooke Thompson. I work and live in the beautiful Queenstown, and I am one of 2% of female qualified electricians in New Zealand.
The golden question like people always ask me, they're always like, why did you want to be a tradie? It was like an economic situation. I had just come back from living in South America. I couldn't afford to go to university, in all honesty. I remember looking at my guy friends who were earning heaps of money and in amazing careers, and I was like, well, why can't I fucking do that? Like, what is the difference? I could go work for minimum wage for the rest of my life, or I could go into the trades and own my own business. I could be empowered. I just couldn't believe that just because I was a woman that this thing wasn't recommended to me, like at school or in society at all. It just had like never crossed my mind. And then when I decided to do it, it was like game over. Like, you couldn't have talked me out of it if you wanted to.
So this house is pretty cool because it's actually the first house I've done start to finish since being qualified. So it's a big deal for me. Hopefully when we turn on and we go for testing, everything, perfect. Perfect first time. I'm just gonna wire up the hot water cylinder, Kiri. The first year of my apprenticeship was just like a nightmare. I don't know why I stayed in it, but like I just felt so like rejected by everyone. That like active disrespect, the making me feel small, the making me feel like I was nothing more than like tradie Tinder. Like you could swipe right on me when I came on site, you know, like, but I just knew that like what was happening wasn't right. I had something to prove. I think if I gave up, then all those people would have won. And I couldn't let them have that, like never. So I just kind of kept going. So for a lot of the men that I've worked with, I am the first woman they've ever worked with. So I'm sort of like a guinea pig at times, testing where the boundaries lie. I think that the culture is like pretty bad. And I hate when people say like it's one or two bad eggs, because I think of all the times I've been harassed on site, there's been other men around, and those other men didn't say anything or they laughed, and that's what hurt most. It's a hard balance, I find, of like being honest with what I've been through and not like sugarcoating it or glossing over the hard stuff. But also at the same time, like still encouraging women, like it's an amazing career and a really cool industry. When I started my apprenticeship, I didn't know any qualified tradeswoman of any kind. And it was really hard to picture myself having a life in this industry because I couldn't see anyone who had done it at all. So I felt like quite lonely. And then my sister told me to get on Instagram. Yeah, I made friends with all these incredible women who were so supportive and had been through similar things that I had been through. And we would joke about like the smell of the portaloos and what to do when you got your period on site. And it was just like this wealth of knowledge that I never had access to. And I was just over the moon. Like it just completely changed my life. Something really interesting is I've seen statistics where like the rates of women in construction have risen and then dropped and risen and dropped. And we're encouraging all these women to get into construction, but we're not actually protecting them. I'd love to own a company. I'd love to call it like Girl Power Electrical or something like that. That would be awesome. And just make opportunities for women, employ women, train women. It's not about giving them just the opportunity. It's about making sure that they feel supported when they have that opportunity as well. You're gone. Have a look at that.
Oh, that's pretty good.
Sometimes I'm not completely useless, you know?